Hey YouTube, today we're learning how to export parts from Bricklink Studio and order them on Bricklink. Hey everyone and welcome to Brick Talk TV. Hope you're well. In our episode today, we're continuing our theme around the Bricklink Studio. And what I want to do today is actually show you how you can export your design files and actually upload them to Bricklink in order to order the parts. So now the tool is a great option in terms of building your own MOCs. And if you missed the video that I did last time about orientation around using Bricklink Studio, then do check the link up in the top right here to see how that all comes together. But this is the second part. So once you've built your MOCs and you've got your designs all in the design files, how do you actually use that to order the parts that you need? So today we're going to jump into that and take a look at how you can use Bricklink to order the parts. So if you remember at the end of our last episode, coming into the Bricklink Designer Studio file here, you can see that we ended up with these four bricks, and this is what we're going to use today as a simple example of how you can export these and upload the file into Bricklink to actually order these four bricks. And of course, if you have a larger mock, then this is going to be quite a lot of bricks. So for this example, it probably doesn't really make sense because it'd be quite easy to order these four parts. But if you had a large mock with like 4,000 pieces of different types, then being able to use the file all in one place and upload it is a game changer, as you'll be able to do it a lot quicker and be able to source the right parts. So back to this, if you remember last time, we split this out into two steps within here. We've got an instruction manual as well, but what we want to do really is export the parts up into Bricklink. So let's flip over first off into Bricklink and log into it itself. So this is the website, same as we saw last time. I'm going to log in this time though, and the menu across the top here is going to change into what my logged in menu will be, and you'll see a few more options sort of around this community and sale tab which will be available to me once I've logged in. Now I've logged into my account, you can see I've got my store, so if I was a seller I could actually organise my sales and upload my parts into this area. I've got my Bricklink which gives me all the details of my actual profile and different things like orders I've got on there. And then you've got the want, which is the wanted list. And that's what we're going to use today in order to be able to capture all the parts that we've designed in our design file and then start to be able to use them and be able to start to buy them so we can build our model itself. So if I click on the want option, you'll be taken to this menu here. You can see here all the different parts that I've ordered before from different sets. Some of these are actually ones I've designed myself. Some of these are actually from other designs that I've purchased on Rebrickable, which is a great marketplace if you want to pick up other people's mock designs. Here you can see this particular one is a Lego campus which we'll be building if we haven't already on a live stream on the channel. This was a staff exclusive set, only given to employees when the new Lego campus opened in Billund. It was only given to people that worked in Denmark or actually on the campus, so as a staff member I didn't actually get this set. But I did manage to track down the instruction manual, and from that I managed to capture all the parts. And as you can see, if I click onto this, you can see it lists out all the different parts here that are required. And the wanted number on this side tells you how many pieces you want, and then of course the have is how many pieces you actually do have already on that particular piece. And that's great because if you've already got an inventory of spare parts, you can of course export the file, and we'll show you how to do that in a second, from Bricklink into here, and you can go through and you can also start to put in how many of these you've already got, which then takes it off the actual number of pieces that the system will order when you go through to the buy option. But before we get into that then, let's go actually back to how we upload our own wanted list. So you can see across the top here we've got the wanted list, which are existing ones. We've got the upload option, which we'll do in a minute. We've got the part out option, which can take some existing models that you know already, and it will give you all the different details of the parts there. So if you're looking for, say, an old Lego set and you want to rebuild it without the instructions and the original set, you can use that here to go in and you can look up particular sets here. So for instance, if we wanted to look up the Barracuda Bay, we could choose a set here, and then it gives you the different options for the themes or the categories. Let's see if we've got that Black Sea Barracuda, so it'd be under Pirates. If we scroll down here, might be Legoland Pirates. No. There we go, Pirates. There's a few different categories here, so we might not find it. Then it'll give you all the different little sets, from small ones right up to large ones that were ever released around here. I don't know if we can... There we go. So if we put black into here, into the search, we can see that there's this Black Sea Barracuda set here. If we click on that, choose item, then it's going to also say, do you want to just have all the parts, the minifigures, do you want the box as well? So you can buy the box on here, the instructions, and then you'd submit that after you've put in a pirate ship wanted list. It would then create a wanted list of this particular type with all the parts in. In fact, let's just do that for an example. So I've already done it now, so I'll call it Pirate Ship Now, press submit, and here you can see all the different parts here that we'll need in order to build the Black Sea Barracuda. So this is a great option if you've got any old sets that you had as a child that you want to get hold of that you can't get hold of anymore, and it's possibly a cheaper way of getting them rather than paying through the nose, either through the marketplace or on eBay. But do check out, because it'll be able to give you a total. So if we go to the upload option then, to start us off, we need to decide the wanted list. There's a default one where everything kind of goes, which isn't advisable because then you start to mix up the different sets. But you can create your own ones. If you scroll right to the bottom of the list, there's a create new wanted list option there. If we select that and give this a name, so we can do a wanted demo, we'll call this. And then we can browse for the file. So this now is the actual design file that Studio has created. So when I created the four bricks in our last episode, I saved the file. And it's saved to my desktop, and that's the extension of that file is a .io file, and of course you could then import that into other Studio files if you move between different machines, or if you opened it in Lego Designer, it should open as well. But for our purposes here, we're going to actually upload the file, and you can see here the different types of files that this platform accepts. So you don't have to just use the Lego Studio file designer, you can also use LDraw, Lego Digital Designer file, so an LXF. So it's an LDR and a BSX, which is the brick stock or brick store file. So we click browse, we'll then take a look on the desktop, and we'll grab hold of this bricks, which is the file that we created last time. Click open. It's validated that this is a valid file that the system can process. It will reject it if there's any corruption or anything wrong with the file, if it's the wrong format, for instance. And then we proceed to verify items. Of course, this is quite quick because we've only got four pieces in our particular design file, but it can take a couple of seconds if you've got a larger file. And you can see here that it's identified that we've got three of these tan coloured 3004 bricks, 1x2. You've also got one of this bright light orange brick, because we did change one of the colours. So it's identified all the parts. Sometimes if you've designed things without ticking that colour option, which I showed you in the last episode, so therefore you're just using all of the palette with all of the different pieces, which is can be tricky because Lego doesn't make all the parts and all the pieces, then the system will probably still try to process this, but probably show it without an image, or it may flag as you're going through the verification process that this part doesn't exist, in which case you'd have to remove it from the wanted list or the model. So it's a good way also to capture things that you might need to substitute out in the model, so for something that is actually available. Anyway, once you've done that, you can just double check the quantities. You also have the option here to choose the condition. So by default it goes to any, but if you're particular about the parts you get, you can also choose that you want new options only, which is probably quite helpful if you want, say, white bricks, which can get discoloured over time. If you just want new ones of those so that they'd be really white, then choose the new option. If you're only interested in used, of course, you can also select that, which will be slightly cheaper in the marketplace, as those bricks will have some slight play worn on them, and you can choose that. So as I said, the default is any. You can also set your max price if you want to. I never really do that because I like to see what the market says. Verify the quantity. You can here, quantity field, again, is what I said earlier, where you can check your inventory. So when you're going through this, if you see, oh, actually, I've got two tan bricks already, we can just increase this and say we've got two. So we'll only be looking for one when we actually go through to purchase, but I haven't got any at the moment. You can make a little note here as well. If there's a particular thing like, oh, I must check my Lego brick box, because I might have this piece, just to remind you if you're going to come back to this later, you can write little notes. You can tick the notify option, which means that if the part is out of stock on the website at the moment, you'll be notified as soon as there is a seller that's going to advertise this particular part. So if you're looking for a rare part or there's low quantities, you might want to tick this option. Again, I don't normally. And then you can exclude. So if you don't actually want to include this in the list that you're going to go through to purchase with, then this is the one that you tick. So a use case of this would probably be if you parted out a large set, as I showed you earlier, like the Barracuda Bay, but maybe you didn't want the minifigures. So you could go through this list and you could tick the exclude option next to all the minifigure parts, and then you would only order the parts for the ship, not the minifigures, which can be helpful if they're particularly expensive, as an example. So you probably would want to use it in that situation. Anyway, with this list, I'm quite happy. So then I click Add Wanted List. Now it's created that wanted list in my wanted list options. If I go to it, you can see how it's transferred now into the list. So now the next step, of course, is once you've got the wanted list and you've imported them into Bricklink, is, well, how do I actually buy these parts? And you've got a couple of options in terms of how you go about this. You might want to stagger the amount that you purchase. So maybe you can't afford to buy all these parts at once, because some of them can be quite expensive. In which case, you can go through and you can actually just tick this option here. And you see, as soon as I've ticked that, this buy one selected button is highlighted, so I can actually check out. And I can just tick the number that I want, or you can actually tick the whole page. If you want to do the first page, just tick this box at the top, and it will auto select all the things on that particular page. This is very helpful, as I said, if you've got a larger set, and you can actually change the number of parts per page to 100. So sometimes when I'm building my larger mocks, the way that I sort of track what I've ordered is, if I get paid, I might order one page, wait a month, then order the next page, wait a month, etc., until I get paid. And that's a nice way of keeping track. And of course, when you get those parts sent to you by the sellers, you can come into your wanted list and you can update the have option, which is what I do, just to make sure that I'm keeping track of all the parts that I've ordered, which ones still haven't been sent through, which things are still outstanding, do I need to place another order because something's gone wrong or been cancelled. If, however, you just want to buy all of the parts, you don't need to select any of these things, then you can just click the buy all option straight away, in which case it will then take all of the parts on all in the whole wanted list, even if they're not included on this page, and it will pass it through into the purchase option. So if we click that for today's example, this then takes you through to the sort of the buying process of it. So you can see at the top here, you've got a few options. I can either order my parts from everywhere in the world or where there's a marketplace. I can restrict it to a continent. And you see, as I select that, the number of sellers changes under here. And I can choose different areas here, like Africa, Asia, Australasia, Australia and Oceania, Europe, European Union, Middle East. So it can go through all these different continents. Or if I'm country specific, which is my usual sort of default mode, I want to look for these parts only in the UK, mainly because of shipping costs and also the speed of which delivery comes is usually a lot better the closer that the area is to your sellers. Of course, if you get a rare part, then you might want to start in the UK, and if you can't find a particular minifigure or a particular part, you might then want to broaden your search, and I might want to go as far as Europe, and I have ordered parts from, say, the Czech Republic before, from Germany, from Italy, where I've struggled to get the parts in the UK, and I've even gone as far as Canada to get some minifigures before. So that's quite a good way to broaden your horizons. You can also, if you're in different countries, change the currency. So if you want to deal in euros only, then you can change this as well. So it will only show you the shops that are selling in euros or in dollars or whatever your particular preference is. Once you've decided that, so we'll stick with the UK. We've got all the UK sellers here that do all of those bricks. You can, if you want, have a scan down the list. So you can see this is the name of the shop. You can see the rating. They've had 1,016 reviews here. They've got a little seller badge here based on their feedback. You can see that the number of unique lots. So we've got two different types of bricks in our lot here. So it's got both of those. And it's actually got 17 of those in stock. It does have a minimum buy of £5 though. So if the bricks that we're ordering today doesn't meet the £5 threshold, then we would have to look for something else within that shop in order to reach that threshold before this seller would actually bother to sell to us. And so you can go down here, and if you've got a particular favourite store or one that you've used before, you can select it if you like by pressing the select option. Or what I tend to do is actually press this auto select, and this auto select will try to work out the best price for you. I mean, it's not always accurate, and sometimes you may save a few pence if you go through and do it manually, but for me, in terms of taking up my time and my life, I just prefer to press this auto select option. Once you press it, it will then ask you if you are actually willing to include shops that you are below the minimum threshold to purchase from, in which case it will still select the bricks from that shop, but then you will, when you go through to checkout, be prompted to actually order more parts in order to hit that threshold. So it's not a way to get around the thresholds, it's just saying, hey, I'm okay to include stores that I might not hit the minimum buy for at this time. But so if you've got a unique or rare brick that only one seller is selling, but there's a minimum threshold of £5, you might have to choose that store, in which case when you go through, you might have to go back to that store and try to bump up your order to hit £5 by maybe ordering a few minifigures or some other parts you need for another set. So it's worth thinking about that. So I'm going to unselect this. So I only want things that I can actually purchase today. I don't want to add anything more. Untick that and click start. Now the system's gone away, and it's found for me that the best store to choose from is Dusty Brick Bin in the UK. We've got got two, we've got four parts, there's 6p item in total for our four bricks, which isn't bad. And if I want to be curious, I can click the edit option and I can actually drill into then what parts it's selected at what price. Again, you can still change the quantity here if you want to, or you can remove certain parts. I do find sometimes when the system's trying to find us the seller that sells the most with the bricks, so it's a sort of a less delivery time or less packages in the delivery, then it may select some stores that have slightly higher prices for certain items just so they can package it together. So sometimes it's worth looking in here just to see if there's a really high priced part that you want to think, actually, maybe I should delete that one. And then you can update the basket as appropriately. Then if I'm happy with this, then I just click this create cart option. It's now created a cart for me with Dusty Brick Bin. And then I go to checkout, and then that'll take me through to verify how much does it cost, if I'm happy with the total cost, because some do actually have shipping and handling fees. So you can see there's a £2.90p charge on top of this for the shipping and also the handling. So the seller will charge, some, not all sellers charge a handling fee for sitting down and sorting the bricks out, packaging them up and then sending them. If I'm happy with still with £2.96, I can proceed to checkout. I can read the terms, I can agree to those. I can do my shipping address, which I've done on the previous screen, and then I can choose how I want to pay. Most people take PayPal, some take Stripe. Those are generally the main ways to pay. If I'm happy with that, I can select that. Then I can choose my shipping option. As you change the shipping option, of course, it does change how much you get charged for shipping. So at the moment, we're at £2.96 for second class. If I want first class, that's now changed to £3.36. If I'm totally happy with that, I can click the checkout with PayPal option. It will then take me through to the PayPal checkout screen to verify and authorize the payment. Once that's done, it will take me back to the stores page on the website and say thank you for my order. Then all you need to do is sit back and wait for the order to come through in the post. And once it does, as I said earlier, if I go back to the wanted list, if I was sitting here in about a week's time and my delivery had come, I can go into my wanted demo list here, click on it, and then I can update and say, yep, I've had the delivery of one bright light orange brick and I've had two or three of the tan bricks. Change, click save, and then it's all updated what I've got. If I refresh the page now, it's also got this nice handy bar at the top here to tell me how much percentage complete my order is for that. And you can see I'm now 100% complete. And so if we went back to the Bricklink file, you can see that I'll be ready now to start building my model. Now I've got all the parts. And I can then use the instructions generated by Bricklink Studio in order to follow the step-by-step guide in order to put these bricks together into the mock or model that I've created. And that's how you bring the Bricklink Studio digital interface to life through the wanted list on the Bricklink website. Of course, there are actually other websites that allow you to do the same thing. Typical examples of ones that I've used before as well are Brick Owl, and you can check that out. I'll put a link in the description below. They've got a similar way of uploading the design file, then having a wanted list and being able to find other buyers. And I do use that now and again, but my go-to website is really Bricklink to get the parts. If there's a particularly rare part or if I'm struggling with price, I might check Brick Owl out as a comparison website almost to see if I get a better deal there. So those are two that spring to mind. If you use any yourself, then do stick them in the comments below, because I'd love to check out some new websites that I'm not aware of as well. But Brick Owl and then the Bricklink ones are the main ones. So I hope you found that useful today in terms of how do we bring to life the digital models through to actually getting the physical brick to help build it. If you did, do hit that like button as it helps others find this channel and also this video. And also hit that subscribe button for other useful tips in terms of building your own mocks and own city in the future. As I said, you'll see me use Bricklink Studio throughout my rebuild of Bricktown, of which I'll put a playlist link here in the top right if you've missed any of that. And I order the bricks in this fashion in order to build some of the items that you'll see in Bricktown as well. So that's how it all comes together. So with that, enjoy yourself with whatever you're doing. Happy building, and I'll see you next time.